To the Lamb of God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We just thank you, Almighty God, for you are a mighty God, Lord God. You are worthy of the glory and the honor and praise, Lord God. For this is a day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for my God is not dead. My God is alive, and we are full of life this morning because he breathed breath in our bodies this morning. He woke us up this morning. He put us in our right mind this morning. He let the joy of the Lord become our strength in him, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, as we praise you, Lord God. Oh God, we give you glory, Lord God. We repent for all sins, omission and commission, Lord God. Anything that we have done wrong, Lord God, we ask you to forgive us, Lord God. For you are a mighty God, Lord God. We love you this morning. We call upon your mighty name, Lord God. Oh God, we seek your face this morning, Lord God. For you we know, Lord God, that all things are in your hands, Lord God. That you are the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end, Lord God. There is none like you, Lord God. We worship you, Lord God. Oh God, we just thank you, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for the sick on today, Lord God. You said let the sick say that they are healed, Lord God. It's by your stripes, Lord God. We speak and decree the word right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. For there is power, power in the word. We decree the word right now, Father. And Father, we thank you for those, Lord God, that has suffered, lost on this week, Lord God. We lift them up to you, Lord God. We lift the Jones family up to you, Lord God. We lift the families of them children, Lord God. 4 children that was killed in that accident, Lord God. We lift them families up to you, Lord God. Strengthen them, Lord God. Encourage their hearts, Lord God. Hide them up under your shadow, your wings of protection, Lord God. All that's going on in this earth, Lord God, we cast it upon you, Lord God, because you knew from the very beginning, Lord God, oh God, that all this was going to happen, Lord God. But you said in your word, you got the whole world in your hand, Lord God. You laid down your life for us, Father God, and we want to thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you for the word on today, Lord God, as it come forth, Lord God, as you use the man of God for your glory on today, Lord God. We thank you for the woman of God, Lord God, as you use her, God, for your glory on today, Lord God. We thank you for the choir, Lord God. We thank you for unifying their voices on today, Lord. We thank you for the musicians, Lord God, using them for your glory, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for those on Facebook on today, Lord God. If they hear, Lord God, if they open up their hearts on today, Lord God, and they receive the word, Lord God, then let this word come in, Lord God. Let it saturate the heart, Lord God. Let it change them on today, Lord God. Let you be glorified in the earth on today, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for the turning that's going on, Lord God. But it's in you that we trust, Lord God. For you are the God that can do a ceiling above anything that we ask and think, Lord God. And we thank you. And we glorify you. We love you this morning, Father. We lift our voices to you, Lord God. We lift our hands to you, Lord God. We say hallelujah to you, Lord God. Hallelujah is the highest praise, Lord God. Oh, glory to your name, Lord. We worship you, Lord God. And we give you glory and honor. It's in your mighty name that we do pray. In Jesus' name. Everybody say amen, 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 amen.
The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? I will wait on you.
I will trust in you.
I will trust in you. I will wait on you.
Come on, say, I will wait.
I will wait on you.
I will trust.
I will trust in you.
I will trust in you.
I will trust in you.
Everybody, I will remain.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will remain.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Listen, everybody. We set our hope on you. We set our hopes on your love. We set our hopes on the one who is the everlasting God. You are the everlasting God. We set our hope.
We set our hopes on you. We set our hopes on your love.
Unison.
We set our hopes. everlasting God. You are the everlasting God. You are the everlasting. We set our hopes on you. We set our hopes on your love. We set our hopes on no one who is the everlasting God. You are the everlasting God.
Come on, give me three parts.
We set our hopes on you. We set our hopes on your love. We set our hopes on no one who is the everlasting God. You are the everlasting God. You are the everlasting. We set our hope on you. We set our hope for your love. We set our hope for no one who is the everlasting God. You are the everlasting God. You are the everlasting.
We set our hope.
We set our hope on you. We set our hope on your love. We set our hope on no one who is the everlasting God. We set our hopes on the one who is the everlasting God.
He's the everlasting God.
You are the everlasting God. You are the everlasting.
I will remain.
I will remain confident. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
You ought to tell somebody, I'm going to remain.
See the goodness of the Lord.
Yeah, come on, tell yourself, I'm going to remain.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will wait on you.
Yes, yes.
I will wait on you. Keep trusting. I'm gonna keep trusting. I'm gonna keep trusting. Keep trusting in you. And I will remain whole, confident in this. I will remain confident. Done enough for me to remain confident in you, just to see the goodness of the Lord.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Everybody. and say awesome.
Awesome. Awesome.
Everybody say
awesome.
My God.
My God is awesome.
Yeah. He's awesome.
Awesome.
Come on, somebody say
awesome.
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 My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
He's the Savior of the whole
Savior
world.
Of the whole world. Giver of salvation.
By His stripes.
By His stripes I am healed. My God is awesome.
Today.
Today I am forgiven.
Come on, His grace.
Grace is why I'm living.
Praise.
Praise His holy name. Awesome.
You ought to shout if you know He's awesome.
Awesome.
Everybody say
awesome. My God is awesome.
He's awesome.
Awesome.
Everybody shout
awesome.
Hey, hey.
Awesome.
Now let's take it home. Oh, He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty. He's mighty. He's mighty. He's mighty, awesome, awesome.
Come on, shout. He's holy.
He's holy. He's holy. He's holy. He's holy. Awesome.
Everybody shout awesome.
Awesome.
He's great.
He's great. He's great. He's great. He's great. Awesome.
If you know He's great, say
awesome.
Oh, He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty. Shout, He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty. He's mighty.
Awesome. Everybody sing.
Awesome.
Oh, deliverer.
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 Yes, she is.
Deliverer.
Oh. He's holy.
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 Awesome. Everybody say
awesome.
I know Him as a provider.
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 Awesome. Yeah.
Awesome.
Well, not only that, but He's my protector.
Protect.
Yes, He is.
Protect.
He's a hedge.
Protect.
Yes, He is.
Protect. Awesome.
He's awesome. He's awesome.
Awesome.
Oh, one more time. Say, He's mighty.
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 Shout.
Awesome.
Oh.
Awesome.
My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
He can move.
He can move mountains.
Keep me
in the valley.
Hide me from.
Hide me from the rain. My God is awesome.
He heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I am weak.
Praise.
Praise His holy name.
Hallelujah.
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 My
God is awesome. Hallelujah. My God, my God. He hides me from the rain. Bless His holy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I stand before you to do the offering this morning. And I come before you from 2 Corinthians 9:6-8. But this I say. He which sows sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which sows bountifully should also reap bountifully. Every man according as he purposed in his heart. So let him give not grudgingly or necessarily,
For God love is a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that he also having all sufficiency in all things may to every good work. I have read that pastoral scripture because I know if you sow sparingly, you will reap sparingly. If you sow bountifully, you will reap bountifully. I said that to say this. I have been out of work ever since January, and I don't had a stroke since then. I went to the emergency room, and I went with dizziness and all kinds of side effects, and I took an MRI. They couldn't find that. They discharged me something back home. Before I could get out of the emergency room, I was waiting on my wife to come. I felt dizzy. The room was spinning and everything. I stumbled to the bathroom. I went to the bathroom. I don't want to make nobody sick. I started doing all of that. And my wife came looking for me, and she had went to the front office and said, you're looking for a man. I think a man been in the bathroom for a long time. And she came and knocked on the door, and I didn't ask who it was. I just opened the door, and she said, babe, you all right? I said, no, look in the commode. And I had all kinds of blood and everything. So she said, you ain't going nowhere. We're going to readmit you back in the hospital. So we got admitted back in the hospital, and they gave me an MRI that time. They still didn't see nothing. So they shot dye up in me, and then they gave me another CAT scan. They said I had a stroke. Well, I say this to say that, but the doctor said, you look like you don't have a stroke. You got all activity of your limbs, your mouth not droop, you got your speech, and everything. So they still diagnosed me with a stroke, so I've been out of work now ever since January with that, and I am waiting on a neurologist to diagnose me. I had an appointment for this month, and I got a letter the other day. They done postponed it to September. I said, Lord, I can't be out of work that long. But I say this to say this. I say in your tithes and offerings, if you sow, and keep God first, hallelujah, he will look out for you.
I thank you.
I didn't say that to say this, but I said, God, you're looking out for me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
But you didn't say things will come easy, but I will look out for you. But ever since January, I can't say I didn't lack, but I'm still not lack for nothing because I am rich in him. Because we sowed. Hallelujah. We sowed. Hallelujah. I thank you. Well, folks, if you keep on giving your tithes and offerings, folks, you will have a testimony just like this. As long as you keep God first and keep your tithes and offerings, God. And we thank you right now, Father God. Father God, we just want to thank you right now, Father God. Father God, we thank you for the set man and set woman of this house, Father God. Father God, we thank you for the musicians on this morning, Father God. We thank you for this choir, Father God. Father God, we thank you right now, Father God. Father God, we give your name all the glory and the honor, Father God. Father God, let this offering be a good work towards your house and your kingdom, God. Father God, we thank you right now, Father God. Father God, we give your name all the glory and the honor. We bless your wonderful name right now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
You ought to look at somebody and tell them, God is an awesome God.
God is an awesome God.
Everybody, God is.
God is an awesome God.
We're going to sing it again. God is.
God is an awesome God. He is an awesome God and greatly to be praised.
Come on, tenor. God is great.
God is great and greatly to be praised.
God is great and greatly to be praised. God is great and greatly to be praised.
Come on, put those hands together, give God the glory.
Amen and amen and amen. Praise be unto our God. Is God worthy to be praised? Or do you have to be promoted by an organ and a pair of drums in order to give God what he's due? But I don't know about you, but my body is an instrument of praise. Come on, tell somebody, my body's an instrument of praise. And I can give him the glory and the honor at any given time. Amen. Let me tell you something. Shake yourself and know that God is worthy to be praised. Come on, put those hands together and give him some love right quick. Amen. He's still on the throne. He is still my way maker. Amen. In a time of trouble, he is still a battle axe. Amen. He's still a shelter in the midst of a storm. He's still my doctor, even in the sick room, and still my lawyer. Amen. When I have to go to a courtroom. Amen. Those old sayings from the old church are still alive even today. Amen. God is worthy to be praised. Amen. I found that praise has the power to back up your enemy and defeat his purpose against your joy. Amen. I've come to understand that if you give him the glory and give him the praise, he'll come down in the midst of your circumstance, in the midst of your dilemma, and he will show himself strong and mighty. Come on, ask somebody. God will show up. Amen. I'm reminded, amen, how the warfare was going against the children of God, and God began to promote the king to get somebody that know how to give me praise. Give me somebody that don't mind shouting, amen? And guess what? He put them all in front of those that knew how to fight. Look at your neighbor and say, this battle is not yours. It belongs to God. I want to say to the young man of God that spoke today, amen, concerned about employment, let me tell you something. God will take care of you, amen. I don't know how he does it, but he makes ways out of no ways. Amen. It's just like that with God. If God can bring water out of a rock, why can't he take care of you? Come on, somebody. If God can cause the Red Sea to dry up and part, well, how come you don't think that he can't take care of you? He's that kind. Oh, you ought to tell somebody, he's just that kind of God. Amen. I know I've learned over the years that God will have you go through some experiences just so you can see another side of him. Amen. That's why he is so awesome, that he's so mighty, because without a test, you can't have a testimony. So ask your neighbor right now. Ask your neighbor, say, neighbor, if you're going through something right now, you're being set up for a testimony. Come on. God needs somebody to talk about his goodness, talk about his faithfulness, talk about his love and his tender mercy. Amen. People always cry out, what can I do? What can I do to glorify God? Take the test. Tell somebody, you got to be willing to take the test so he can turn around and mark your grade and say, you have, amen, made it over. You now have a testimony. Amen. To talk about my goodness, to talk about my greatness. You can't talk about my greatness if I never brought you out of anything. Come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor, it's time, amen, to give God praise. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Don't you ever doubt him. Amen. Because he's always faithful. And that's why we sing the song. Amen. God is worthy to be praised. Don't care what you're facing right now. I want to tell somebody and encourage them. Just keep giving God the glory. Just keep giving God the praise. Just keep lifting your hands and surrender. Come on. And he will take care of you. I've got testimonies to be able to say that I'm not just mimicking what I heard, but I've been through some things. Come on, tell somebody, I've been through some things. So when the preacher start talking about testimonies, I'm in agreement because I got a testimony. Amen. The Lord brought me out, brought me through, brought me over. And he's keeping me right now. If I'm talking about you, you ought to give God a good praise right there.
A good praise. Amen. He's worthy of a good praise. Because he's that kind of God. And he's fair in all his situations. Amen. I stand before you today to, amen, give you a slice, amen, of the word of God. And pray that even as the man of God Elijah, the angel told him, said, go in the strength of that meal. So today I want to give you a meal that will empower your strength so you can go another distance with God. Is that all right? Come on, I give God a good hallelujah. Amen. That sound good enough for me to hear, but let the angels hear you give God a hallelujah. That was all right. That was a little better, but now give a hallelujah that the neighborhood will know. Hallelujah! Amen to Zion. Amen. And to God be the glory. He's worthy of the glory. I want to talk to your hearts this morning, amen, on a subject, anointed with joy. Yes. Anointed with joy. Amen. Anointed with joy. Amen. When you are anointed with joy, amen, things will begin to happen. I'm reminded of the fact that when babies are innocent, they have a beautiful, beautiful spirit. And it's so wonderful to look at babies when they're asleep and they smile. Don't have no teeth in their mouth and they just put a grandiose smile on their face. It just gives you such a great joy to know and see the peace that they have as they are trusting, amen, in their environment. They don't even know what's going on around them, but they're so confident and so relaxed in the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. Amen. They have a connection. It seems like when you walk in innocence, amen, what is innocence? It means you don't have no worries, no care. You're not consumed with problems and situations. Amen. You're able to see that they're able to be happy. Kids can get together and fuss for a few minutes, and the next thing you know, they're back out there playing and carrying on like nothing has ever happened. But as we began to enter into the world of responsibility, as we began to enter into the problems of life, amen, innocence is sometimes stripped away little by little, amen. And then we find ourselves, amen, now competing in life. We find ourselves, amen, fighting to survive just another day. And the joy that God intended, amen, seems to be so far away, amen. But God's word is still, amen, the same. Amen. If God promised you a thing, you need to put it in the bank and know it's going to come to pass. I wish I could talk to somebody right quick. Amen. And so as we continue to venture through life, we find that people stop being happy. Amen. They go through the motions. They put a smile on their face. But deep down on the inside, there's war in their heart. Amen. The Bible says how David begins to talk. He said, listen here, his words were smooth as butter, but in his heart there was war. Amen. And so we find, amen, that as we depart from the spirit of joy, we began to get frustrated in life. We began to walk around like the weight of the world is on our shoulder. And so we need to find out what God really intended. Amen. Did God intend for you to walk around like you've been smacked with a bag of prunes? Or did he, amen, say the joy of the Lord, amen, it will be your strength? I wish I could talk to somebody and make it plain today. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, God doesn't intend for you to walk around with the weight of the world on your shoulders. Amen. Take, amen, a moment and get out of the stress, get out of the press, and learn how to relax and enjoy your life. Amen. I wish I could talk to somebody. God did not save us, amen, to watch us walk around looking like Atlas with
the world on our shoulders. God, whom the Son set free, amen, they're supposed to be free indeed. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, God intends for you to stay free and be free and don't be bound ever again. Amen. So we come to understand that, amen, as I read the word of God, I'm beginning to see some things that I've not seen before. Amen. That's one thing that I love about the word of God is that it's a living word. Amen. It's not a textbook that you read. And when you go back to it, it says the same thing over and over and over again. But it is a living word. And I found out that as your conditions change, amen, God's word will speak to you in that manner. I wish I could talk to somebody. Amen. It's like having a real conversation with a real God that's not, amen, a statue. Amen. It looks the same. It acts the same. You pray and never get a result. But our God is a faithful God. I wish I could talk to somebody. Tell somebody he's a faithful God. And so as I was reading in preparing for the word, I began to talk about this anointing with joy. Anointed with joy. Amen. You're anointed in tongues. You're anointed to preach. You're anointed for this. But I never heard anyone ever say, I'm anointed with joy. Ah, come on, somebody. My Bible says that you have not because you ask not. I hope I perk somebody's, amen, interest to start asking God, amen, what? For the anointing of joy. I wish I could get somebody to say, Lord, just let me have the anointing of joy. Amen. Because the joy of the Lord, what? It will be my strength. So I began to read out of the book of James, chapter 1, verse 2. James, chapter 1, verse 2. And my Bible says, my brethren, count it all joy. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, he didn't say pick, choose, and refuse. He said, count it what? All joy. Count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. I like the way James said it, but I wanted to flip it over and I went to the Living Bible, and the Living Bible, saying the same verse, said it this way. Dear brothers, is your life full of difficulties and temptations? He's asking a question. And most of the time, amen, when you ask somebody, how you doing? Well, you know. It's not an answer of joy or expectation. It's not an excitement about living. Amen. But it says here, then be happy. Uh-oh. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, be happy. Don't worry. Be happy. God says, don't worry. I wish I could get somebody, encourage somebody right now. Don't worry. Amen. Don't you worry about a thing. Look at what he says now. He says, then be happy, for when the way is rough, I wish I could talk to somebody. When the way is rough, your patience has a chance to do what? Grow. Somebody's having growth spurts. Amen. Been a midget for a long time. But now God is prompting your growth spurt. So he says here, so let it grow. What did he say? So let it grow, and don't try to squirm out of your problems. Woo! Look at your neighbors and neighbors. Stop squirming. Stop squirming now. Stop squirming. Just know that God's going to make it all right. Amen. And he goes on to say, for when your patience is finally in full bloom, then you will be ready for anything. Good God Almighty. Woo!
I wish I could talk to somebody. God will allow you to go through some strength exercises because he's got to get ready for you to show off. Good God Almighty. So he can show you off to a people who don't know a God, and they'll wonder how you made it over. Tell somebody, go ahead and work it. Go ahead and work it. Work that patience and watch God move. Work that trial and watch God move. Work that situation and see if God don't show up. Amen. He said, let patience. You can't have patience without having faith. Woo. Let me calm down here. So he says, then you will be ready for anything. Strong in character. You won't be a liar. You won't be a pretender. Because you've been through enough now that, amen, fake stuff don't impress you. I wish I could talk to somebody. It said, full and complete. Full and complete. My Bible says, amen, Proverbs 17:22. He says this, a merry heart doeth good like a medicine. I don't know about you, but look at your neighbor and come on, participate with me. Amen. Even you on Facebook, participate with me. Tell somebody, I'm so medicated, amen, I'm just wrapped up in joy. I'm wrapped up in his arms. I'm wrapped up in his love. I'm wrapped up in my expectation of him because I'm medicated with, amen, the power. Woo! My heart is merry. Because of the fact that I realized that, amen, when you laugh a lot, I wish I could talk, can I preach a message called Laugh a Lot? Amen, tell your neighbor, neighbor, laugh a lot. Because see, if you laugh a lot, you'll feel a whole lot better. Your heart will begin to tick right. Your attitude will begin to change. Your expectation will begin to rise. You'll look younger than looking like you're sad all the time. But, oh, can I preach a message, Laugh a Lot? Tell your neighbor, when I leave out of here, I'm going to laugh a lot. Because I found out that a merry heart. Oh, God, I feel like laughing right now. Come on, tell your neighbor, I feel like laughing right now. I feel like laughing because the joy of the Lord. Somebody say, the joy of the Lord is still my strength. Amen. You got to use that strength when you feel weak. You got to use that strength when there is no hope. You got to use that strength when it seems like you're lost. You got to use that expectation and laugh a lot. Woo-wee. Somebody ought to get out a laugh right now. Go ahead and send out one right now. Woo, put the intimidate that enemy to let him know he can't take away your joy. He can't take away your hallelujah. He can't take away your dance and your skip. I wish I could talk to somebody. Tell your neighbor, anointed with joy. Anointed with joy. You got to pick out things that's going to make you happy. You got to pick out things that's going to get you, put a smile on your face. Stop walking around talking about problems all the time. Go around, talk about God's power. Go talk about God's decisions to make you higher. You talk about laugh a lot. Can I tell you a little story? There was this lady, amen, that decided she was going to exercise. She was kind of huge in numbers. But she got on an exercise bike. It looked like she was sweating. But she got into here, little text that says, I decided to take an aerobics class. And she said, I bent, I twisted, I gyrated, and I jumped up and down for a whole hour. Somebody say a whole hour. Uh-huh. She said, but by the time I got my leotards on, the class was over. See, tell your neighbor, laugh a lot. Come on, laugh a lot.
See, if you're going and laugh and stop being so serious, you might get healed in that liver. You might get healed in that cancer. You might get rid of that problem in your body. But you got to learn how to laugh a lot.
Talking about problems all the time. Amen. When the last time you heard a good clean joke like the one I just told you? Amen. It's getting around things that I remember, amen, a story of a man. He was dying with cancer. Amen. And they put him in the room. Amen. And he was sitting there and they brought him all kinds of comedies. Amen. To cause him to get his mind off his problem. A few months later, he walked out the hospital healed, delivered. And he said, what was the secret? He said, I laughed a lot. Come on, tell your neighbor, neighbor, take the seriousness out of life. And learn how to put on the garment of praise. Learn how to lift your hands and glorify a living God. Come on and celebrate the Prince of Peace. Take the stress out your life. I'm anointed with joy. Woo. You got to realize, amen, that the joy and to laugh and to express high emotions. Stop being so critical. God anoint me with joy. I got another story for you. Another woman said, exercise? Oh, no, not me. I've been hiding from exercise. I'm in the fitness protection program. Always sitting. Some of y'all can't even laugh. You're looking like, hey, man, when the pastor gonna be serious? I'm serious as a heart attack right now. Somebody say, laugh a lot. It'll be the medicine you need to cause that yoke to break in your life. I wish I could talk to somebody. Amen. A merry heart. Am I in the book? A merry heart does what? Does good as a medicine. When I turn to the book of Psalms, chapter 126, and I'm looking at verse 2, the Bible tells me, then was our mouths filled with joy. Somebody say, filled with joy. Look at somebody say, when the last time you had one of them back aching, stomach pulling laughs come out of you? Where you almost had to go to the bathroom because you were laughing so hard. When the last, come on, look at somebody, just tell them, when the last time you had a good laugh? I ain't talking about one of them hee hee. I'm talking about one of those where you got to bend over and try to breathe. I got my laughing partner Janice with me. She'll laugh if nobody else will laugh. Even if it ain't funny, she'll still laugh just the way I look. Anointing of joy. God anoint me with joy. Look at this. He said, then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongues with singing. Then said they among the heathens, the Lord hath done great things for them. Look at that. When people see that you celebrate and you are elated to be in the presence of God, they come to understand that there is a God of joy. There is a God of power. There is a God of an anointing. There is a God that will grace you. Oh, I wish I could talk to somebody. Anointed with joy. Pastor, you don't never look like you go through anything. Why should I look like what I've been through? Come on, tell your neighbor, stop looking like what you've been through. Laugh a lot. My. Always walking around talking about what ain't right. Always criticizing what ain't the way you want it done. That's why you look miserable. Nobody want to be around you. You're like cheap rain in the face. Sunshine everywhere, but when it come around you, the cloud and the rain is running. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, you got to get anointed with joy. Psalmist said that they seen that their laughter, and let me tell you something, it was during a time when they were in captivity, and God finally brought them out. But I want you to understand something. God is not waiting for you to get what you want. He's waiting for you to respond to what he told you. Come on, tell your neighbor, neighbor, God is waiting for you to respond to what he told you. If he told it to you, it's going to happen. Come on, tell somebody, if he told it to you, it's going to happen. Amen. You can put it in the bank. You can expect it just like, amen, emergency mail. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there's an emergency going on, and I'm calling out for the anointing of joy. Amen. This joy, this joy, this joy. Amen. That is so, so awesome. Amen. But one thing in reading James, I come to understand something. Amen. That Job told me in 14:1, there's no escaping problems. Look at your neighbors and neighbor. There's no escaping problems. Job 14:1 tells me a man that is born of a woman is a few days. And what? Full of trouble. Amen. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, stop running and stand and laugh a lot. Oh, y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Come on, tell your neighbor. Talk to the preacher. Talk to the preacher. Talk to the preacher. Stop running. Stand still and laugh a lot. Because it will do something to you. Now, I got to go back to James. Is it all right if I just relate back to James for a minute? James tells us, amen, once again, count it what? All joy. He's telling us no matter what the situation is, count it all joy. Now, it's amazing that God sometimes give me a message, something like this, and then all hell break loose. Why is that? Because the enemy is going to always challenge. I wish I could talk to somebody. That enemy is going to always challenge, amen, your level of expectation, your proof that's in the pudding. He's going to come to see how real. He said, listen here. Job told us, stop running. Amen. Why? Because you're not going to be able to duck it. Amen. God wants testimonies out of his children. Amen. If God allowed it, you're going to come out of it. I want to say something to you. Amen. Listen to what Jesus says in John 5:19. John says in 5:19, listen to this. He says, then answered Jesus and said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, the Son can do nothing what? Of himself. In other words, God is making sure that we all understand how much we need him. You can't be happy without him. Come on. You'll get substitutes. You'll get props. You'll get friends. You'll get neighbors. You'll get family. You'll get cars. You'll get material goods. And guess what? You'll still end up not being happy, because happiness is not in the abundance of the things you possess, but it's walking with God and his favor. I wish I could get a praise in the building. Jesus said, I can do nothing without him. Can't be happy without him. Why? Because there's a void area in all of us that only God can occupy. Amen. You ought to look at your neighbor and say, there's no vacancies here. God is right where he needs to be in my life. Come on, put those hands together. Give God a praise right there. This is our initiator when we read that Jesus said we can do nothing. This is an indicator that we need the Holy Ghost to do the impossible. I tell your neighbor, neighbor, you need the Holy Ghost to do the impossible. It's nearly impossible to be full of joy when your spirit is crushed. It is nearly impossible, amen, to be full of joy when circumstances won't allow you to embrace. I wish I can talk about you. Amen. But one thing I've learned about God, Tiny, is that God cannot ask you to do something that you can't do, because if he ever asks you something, I wish I could talk to somebody. If he ever asks you to do something that he knows you can't do, will make him an unjust God. So if he says, amen, count it all joy, that must mean we got the ability to be happy in trouble. Somebody say the anointing
of joy.
When I read, amen, out of Acts chapter 13, verse 50. Acts 13, verse 50 tells me, but the Jews stirred up the devout and honorable women and the chief men of the city. And they raised up persecution against Paul and Barnabas and kicked them out, expelled them out of their coast. Some of us would be so brokenhearted, so tore up from the flow up, we wouldn't even come back to church. Somebody in the church hurt my feelings. They hurt your feelings on the job, but at 7 o'clock you punch in. Somebody say, laugh a lot. People can mess with you everywhere, and it don't change you at all. But when it comes to the church, because you fleshly anyhow, you find a reason to leave the church. Your problem is not with the church. Your problem is with your deliverance. Oh, come on, somebody, and tell you, you need a deliverance in your life. A deliverance from the preacher, the people, and everybody else, and learn to focus in on why you're in the building. Why do you come to the building? Because God gave me a promise. He said, where two or three gather in my name, I'll be in the midst. And whenever God is in the midst, I can ask them what I want. I can laugh a lot if I like. I can jump up for joy. I can have peace of mind. I wish I could get a praise to hear. Hey, the Lobo Shanda. Look at what Barnabas and Paul did after being kicked out. Amen. Tell your neighbor, you need the real Holy Ghost. The Bible says in that next verse, but they shook the dust off their feet. When the last time you shook some things off of you? See, you can't shake stuff off. That's why it burdens you. That's why you get burdened down. Burden down, Lord, burden down. Change that song. Huh? Tell your neighbor, change that song. Stop singing them beat up songs. You ain't nobody's punching bag. Go on and sing songs that make you happy. Go on and leap it for joy. Apostle Mel Williams got a song, Leap for Joy. I wish I could get somebody to just stand up and leap right now. Leap for joy. Woo, some of y'all, even my seniors are jumping up. You ought to jump up too. Jump for joy. Amen. Look at what they did. See, this is what it is about, is that when you are anointed with joy, you don't let things pull you down. Listen, I heard something in the Holy Ghost. You don't participate with depression. Let me say that again. You need to stop participating with depression, defeat, and sorrow. You need to leap for joy. You ought to say, God, place on me the anointing of joy. He said, you have not because you ask not. Can you imagine just asking God, I'm unemployed, and the burdens of the bills and the things around me are trying to get me down, but God, right now, I need you to anoint me like you never anointed me before. I need a laugh-a-lot spirit right now. I need the anointing of joy all over my... Look at what it says. They shook the dust off their feet. And look at this next verse. And it says, and the disciples, somebody say, and the believers were filled with joy. And what? With the Holy Ghost. Oh, you need the Holy Ghost to maintain this thing. When James said, count it all joy, he was saying something that will illuminate your understanding. But I'll tell you about it a little later. While under the persecution, they were filled with joy. Look at, did you hear that? Anointed. Somebody say anointed with joy. How is this possible?
What was it that brought about this great phenomenon? Huh? I can't help but believe that somebody had asked God to be their expectation.
I heard Apostle Paul say one time, he said, "What do you mean to break my heart?" He said, "I'm not only, amen, willing to die for the cause of Christ, amen, because I understand how to be content in whatsoever state I'm in. I've got to do the will of God." Come on, give God a good praise here. These disciples were rejected, but full of joy. Look at your neighbor. Say, "Neighbor, can you do that? Can you do that?" Yeah, y'all looking like y'all can do it. Some folk, you know when they're going through, you run the other way. I wish I could talk to somebody. Because you are Atlas holding the whole world on your shoulders. But you ought to tell somebody, "I'm too young to be burdened down." That's right, Brother Quick. Go on and say it. Too young to be carrying the weight of the world. But see, when the Holy Ghost is doing his work in us, we can expect internal peace, joy, regardless of the external circumstances. What are you talking about, preacher? I'm here telling you that our joy should not be based on outside curriculums. Amen. Listen to what John 15, verse 11. John 15, verse 11 says, "These things have I spoken unto you." Listen to Jesus. Jesus said, "I've sent my word and I'm speaking it unto you, that my joy might remain" where? "In you." I'm preaching what? The word of God, that it might do what? Remain in you, filling you with joy. He said that your joy might be what? Full. Tell your neighbor, "Neighbor, did you hear this word this morning? It's time for you to be full of joy." Come on, tell them, it's time to be full of joy. Ask God through the anointing of the Holy Ghost to anoint you with the spirit of joy, unspeakable. Notice the purpose of Jesus teaching to his disciples was their joy to be complete. Because the Holy Ghost is doing, amen, within them and with us, that joy is an internal stability in spite of the external circumstances. Because of what? The knowledge that God is in control. Tell your neighbor, "Neighbor, the active work of the Holy Ghost in me is keeping me happy. Because I know who's in control." Come on. I know who's got the whole world in his hand. I know who's on the throne. I know who has to bow. I know who has to say hallelujah. I wish I had some help, that God is still in control. We got to understand that when James was talking to us, we must understand that there was a uniqueness in that word, "count it all joy." James said, listen here, now I want you to catch this right quick. A lot of times we can have a lot of joy after an experience that creates the joy. I need you to hear what I'm saying. A lot of times our joy is based on something being done. So James can't be talking about ordinary joy. He can't be talking about ordinary joy because he's talking about being in a problem and being in trouble, but count it all joy. When I read you Psalm 126, they had joy and their mouths were full of laughter because God had brought them out. But while they were in, there was an absence of joy. And so James, when he's talking about count it all joy, he can't be talking about ordinary joy. So I began to think about the fact
What is God talking about? And he took me to Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. And he said in his word, but the fruit of the Spirit. Notice it's not outside, but he's talking about something inside. So he said, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, and peace. Now, it's a couple of categories, but I want to talk about this one right here in the middle, talking about joy. That is an internal attribute. Y'all gonna get this. Tell your neighbor, you getting this? Come on, you getting this? See, love, joy, and peace are three attributes which are inward, which means you can access them at any time. If you don't want to love, you can turn it off. Ain't got nothing to do with how somebody else behaves. It's all about what's in you. That's why we need the Holy Ghost. Because when people become unlovable, you got to have the anointing. Somebody say, you got to have the anointing. Easy to love folk when they're doing right. So same thing with that is the same thing with joy. Your problems can't keep pushing you around. Oh, I wish I could talk to somebody. Your problems can't keep pushing you around when you're operating from what's on the inside. Somebody say the anointing of joy. John 14 verse 26 comes right behind and says, but the comforter. Somebody say comforter. I don't know, you can go to the store and buy a comforter. It's so nice and soft. Put it on your bed, you just feel so comfortable. Sleep harder than you ever pretended to sleep. Come on now, oversleep because the alarm didn't work. Because the comforter comforts you to the point where you've just escaped the world. That's what the Holy Ghost does. When he comes and you relate with him in partnership, amen, he'll speak to you in the time of your trouble and let you know on the inside, not the outside, that everything is going to be all right. Tell your neighbor, I feel a laugh a lot. Come on, somebody. Everything. Somebody just holler out, everything going to be all right. So we see here, amen, as we continue to read this verse. Listen to what it says. But the comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance. Whatsoever I have said unto you. Now, the works of the Holy Ghost covers a whole lot. Amen. Because the word comforter is the word in the Greek talk about Paracletus, one called aside to assist and help. What is he? He's our advocate, he's our strengthener, he's our encourager, and one who gives us aid. So if he is all that, come on somebody, he's all that and more. Tell somebody, he's all that and more. Then I need the ability of the Holy Ghost to assist me in my joy because circumstance can defeat me. But when you ask God to anoint you, they'll wonder, how did you make it? You ought to tell somebody, I laughed a lot. Because the joy of, come on, Janice, let me hear a laugh right now. There you go, that's what I'm talking about. See, she don't need to hear a joke, she just need to hear the word, laugh. Anointed. Tell your neighbor, I got a new prayer request. God, anoint me with your joy. He said, step into my presence and it'll be automatic. The enemy wants to bring you into his environment. But see, it reminds me of the battle of the eagle and the snake. Are you hearing what I'm saying? See, the eagle knows that he can't beat the snake on the ground. So what he does, he takes the snake all the way up into the atmosphere. And then he begins to drop the snake. And because the snake doesn't have any footage, tell your neighbor, remove the footage of your enemy. Amen. Get lost in the praise and start giving God the glory. You'll take the problem to a whole new atmosphere. And then as you throw your hallelujah up, you'll begin to dismantle that problem. You'll begin to defeat that situation because of the
talking about, preacher? What are you talking about? I'm talking about today the anointing of joy. The ability to call for the anointing of joy. What do you mean the ability? Tell your neighbor, neighbor, you can call it up when you want it. When I look at the book of Judges chapter 16, Judges 16 verse 20, the Bible says, and Delilah said to Samson, the Philistines be upon you, Samson. And he woke up out of his sleep. And he said, I will do something. I will go out as at other times before and do what? And shake myself. Notice what he said. This ain't my first experience. Come on, tell your neighbor, this ain't going to be my first experience. I'm going to know how to shake myself now. When the enemy try to strap me up and put a straitjacket of fear and doubt and worry onto my life, I'm going to call on the anointing by shaking myself. And then I'm going to start breaking out in a praise, breaking out in a laugh, and giving God all the glory, because I'm going to laugh a lot because of the anointing of joy on my life. And he shook himself. I want somebody in here to know how to shake yourself. When you feel that burden trying to wrestle you down to the floor, you look up to heaven and say, God, I need the anointing. And guess what happened? God will show up and cause every problem, every situation, every doubtable thing to disappear off of your life. You will have an anointing of oil that will flow on your body that the devil can't even get a grip on your heart. Why? Because of the anointing of joy. Somebody holler out joy. Nehemiah said, the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord. I stay in his presence. I have access. I want to read one more verse and I'm done. Because if you ain't got it by now, go home and tell yourself some jokes. You need to go get a joke book. Got to be a clean one, though. Don't be going out here getting a crazy one. 1 Samuel chapter 30, and I'm closing. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6. The Bible says, and David was greatly distressed. Greatly. He didn't just say he was distressed. He was greatly distressed. Look at your neighbor and say, have you ever been able to identify with that word greatly? Huh? Distressed. Paul said, I at one time in my life, amen, it was above my strength. I wish I could talk to somebody. It said they were so distressed because the enemy had came in their camp and destroyed everything that they loved. Took their families away. And their hearts were broke and grieved. They cried so hard they didn't even have strength. Had no more strength. Then they turned around and tried to find blame. They talked about stoning David. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, after all you've done, people will still find fault with you. But shake it off. I wish I could talk to somebody. He said, listen here, for the people spoke of stoning David because of the soul of all the people was grieved. Every man for his sons and for his daughters. Now that kind of threw me for a loop right there because it didn't say nothing about the wives.
You'll catch that 3 o'clock in the morning. But here we see that they were so grieved and depressed after David had done all he did, trained them how to fight. They became men of great excellence and power. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there is something that will rock your world from time to time. And you'll need the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. But when it comes to the point where your life is being threatened, that they're talking about killing you, David shows us something about the anointing of joy. The Bible says, but David, look at your neighbor as a neighbor. Say, but put your name in it. But Kenny, despite all the pressure, despite all the obstacle, despite all the setback, despite all the negativism, despite all the what you ain't and what you can't, oh, come on, somebody, trying to kill your motivation, trying to kill your expectation, trying to stop you from believing God, trying to convince you it'll never change. But David, oh, encouraged himself. Nothing around him to help him. Nothing around him to encourage him. Nothing around him said, David, you're doing a good job. Nothing around him said, you'll make it. Nothing around him. But there was something on the inside. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, no matter how bad it gets, there's something on the inside. But David, tell your neighbor, but David, encouraged himself in the Lord his God. And something must have happened. Something must have happened. What you mean something must have happened, preacher? Something must have happened because they talked about stoning him, but after he encouraged himself in the Lord, things changed. Tell your neighbor, all you got to do is change. And you'll change everything around you. Take off that garment of heaviness. Put on the garment of praise. Take that ash off of you. And let God clothe you with his goodness and his mercy. Tell your neighbor, laugh a lot. The anointing of joy. I pray that this message today has done something for your inner man. Not concerned about your outer man. Your outer man is fickle. Your outer man, until you renew your mind, will change with the circumstances. When you renew your mind in the Word of God, and you trust in the ability of God, I don't know why I keep looking at you tonight, today. I want to tell you, God said, take them shoes off and dance like you always need to dance, because you're going to dance a miracle right into your life. Go ahead and dance a miracle right into your life, Seal. I don't know why all through this message I keep looking at you and the word joy just keep coming on me, but God said, go ahead and dance yourself right into a miracle. Ah, y'all ought to help her dance herself right into a miracle. God is up to something. I don't know what it is, but he's going to do it for you. Don't you count it out. Don't you look at it as a problem, but give God the glory. Give him praise right now, because the yoke is destroyed. Somebody praise him right now. Woo! Somebody say, laugh a lot. Sounds like the Holy Ghost to me. Bring that baby. Tell that baby come here. I'm coming up against it. Ah, the devil is a liar. Come on. Somebody say the devil is a liar. You can go ahead and cut that tape, brother. Amen. Come on and give God the glory.